Scrap Mechanic Update 0.5 just released, and I'll be going through all the new features for you. The creative worlds have been updated, and now feature destructible trees and rocks. So you can finally test your woodcutting and mining vehicles. Most importantly, we finally got water in creative. Real, actual water. That still doesn't fix the broken water physics, but anyway, we've got water. The water goes once around the map, so you can race your friends in boats, according to the devs. This also made the creative world slightly larger, but still not large enough to build a graveyard while the walks we didn't save. Well, but if you wanted big ocean worlds, I'm sorry to disappoint you, because we only got lake tiles in World Builder. Because lakes, that's definitely what we wanted, and not big ocean worlds. But I'm sure they're going to be amazing water tiles in the workshop. And there's also breakable corn now, if you're into that type of thing. I mean, I don't judge, but it doesn't even drop real corn. Of course, we also got amber trees in creative now, because amber trees are also trees. I'm all in for tree equality. But we don't get amber either. However, if you want to experience these new epic creative worlds, you'll have to create new worlds. Your existing creative worlds will stay the same. And the flat worlds look like a nuclear wasteland now. I wonder what flat worlds would look like if the floor was made out of sunshade. Ooh, I can change that. Oh god. Well, this looks amazing, but I'm kinda getting distracted with the update, so let's get back to it. And of course, we've got the new and shiny bot capsules for creative now. Simply shoot them or hit them with your hammer to open them. And then get stabbed brutally in your ribs multiple times as you realize you're a god. Kinda like Prometheus, but you're a god. Hey! More on bot combat later. You can feed woks and glow bugs like you would in survival, but they don't drop any milk or glow poop. And they also added corn to survival, which doesn't drop from corn in the world. Well, and neither do haybots drop these annoying metal parts that take so long to refine. And the same especially applies to these annoying toadbot heads. Like seriously, if you wanna have a virtual egg hunt, just go in your survival world and try grabbing all those toadbot heads that lie everywhere. Well, and neither do any of the other bots drop anything. Well, and the red tape bot has a screw stuck in his head now. I guess he's screwed. We can also paint bot capsules. What is this good for, you might ask? Well, bot fights! In the first corner, blue hay bot.
I like food.
And in the second corner, red hay bot.
I like red.
3, 2, 1, fight! And blue spot charging, red bot got the first hit, and it's a fight! And blue haybot won! Blue haybot is the strongest bot in the world! And yeah, this is still sponsored by Sunshake. Yeah, any bots of different color will now attack each other. That's actually kinda racist, but yeah. Well, but it's also a lot of fun. Nope, not me. But keep in mind that this only applies to bot capsules. You can change the color of the capsule itself, but these walks won't fight each other. I guess the devs have morals after all and don't allow for enemy fights. Although I would like to see who's the strongest walk, because Sunshake makes you strong. I'll get to the new chat commands in a minute, but first we've got new gameplay options. And by gameplay options I mean one single physics quality slider. And now this thing gets really interesting. For example, if you have lots of objects simulated by these logic gates, the game can get very laggy. But if we now go into the gameplay settings and turn down the physics quality to simple 1, we can see the game runs much, much more smoothly. Like it's actually playable after all. I mean, that is if you ignore this weird logic gate shaking now. Well, if you think you can finally run Scrap Mechanic on your potato PC now, I've got to disappoint you. Because physics quality 1 comes at a price. Forget suspensions and bearings. Like, this does not work at all. And if I turn the quality up, actually, the physics should be less broken. I swear. The physics are a little less broken. Well, and in survival, we've got the new difficulty slider, which we can set to easy, which seems to halve the damage we take from bots, as Jonathan Raymaker showed. And the game also now fades to black when we respawn, to mock you even more. Man, they should have added the you died screen from Dark Souls. And the game also now fades to black when we respawn, to mock you even more. Also, collision and fall damage is tweaked, so we only take a maximum of 50 damage, so I guess a few broken bones aren't so bad after all. Makes it kinda too easy, I think. Oh, that only happens if our difficulty is set to easy. Also, the gameplay settings should be saved individually for each world, So if you set one world to easy, you might still be playing a normal on the other world. Because if we now turn it up to normal, so I guess easy mode halves all our damage we take. And I think tweak collision damage means we shouldn't get the weird bug where we only take 99 fall damage. And yes, it seems to be that way now. And yet, we also take less damage from flames. So yeah, easy mode halves all damage you take. Well, and the main menu changed again. Now we can show off amazing builds or build a huge giant Simply click on this blue icon here and you can start at working on your new build. And they also changed loading screens. Well, and once you enter this build mode, don't get your hopes up too high, because certain items like the piston aren't even available here. There are bearings. Not even bearings! We don't even have a connection tool? However, you can spawn in these forbidden parts. However, even if you place moving creations here, they won't move in the title screen. Which kind of makes sense if you don't want to break your game already by starting it if you place down 130 bearings or something crazy like that. We also got new chat commands for creative. For example, if we type /night, the game time will turn to night, and now we can have epic lights. And if we type /day, we can turn the game back to daytime. With the /noaggro command, we can prevent bots from attacking us. The /noaggro creations command will prevent bots from attacking our creations, which is really useful if you don't want bots to destroy your creations, like these tape bots really like to do. With the aggro all command, you can make all bots attack you, but only if the noaggro command is turned off. And that's a lot of toad bots coming for me. Time for my secret weapon, the paint tool. With the /drop scrap command, we can make our hay bots drop scrap again. Yay, if you like these, because they're so oddly annoying. But hey, you can also see the refine time is finally faster! The /pop capsules command will pop all capsules. That looks fun. And with /kill all, we can get rid of all bots again. So it's not as laggy anymore. The /place tree command will place a random tree. You can also specify which tree, either birch, spruce, leafy, or pine. And of course, we can also place stones. The /restrictions command allows us to remove some restricted parts, such as tree parts. And lastly, there's the /clear command, which will remove all creations from our world. But we need to allow it first with the allow clear command. And once clear is enabled, we can type /clear, and this pop-up will come up. And now all creations are removed. So if you decide to spawn in my 130 bearings tower, you can save your world by typing /clear now. Hooray! And luckily this command can only be used by the host, so no mean friend can destroy your entire world. Also, keep in mind you have to retype some commands once you spawn in your world again, like the noaggro command. If we press the arrow keys in the chat window, we can copy our previous messages. The craft bot is also now in creative. We can craft whatever we want, and we can upgrade the craft bot as much as we want. But as soon as we add one of these newly added chests to the craft bot, things will actually require items to craft. Well, I guess this is kind of useful if you want to test a woodcutter, because we also got the resource collector now in creative, and the refinery. We also have vacuum pumps now in creative, as well as vacuum pipes and the water container, which we can use to power the water cannon. And we've got our trusty old bucket as well, so if we want to do things more manually. We've also got glow sticks now too. Now I only wonder what would happen if I throw 1000 of them. Beacons are also available in creative now. You can configure them as you normally would, but you don't have a logbook, so I can't turn them off individually, nor can I see how far away I am from them. I mean, it's better than nothing, and it still helps my terrible navigation skills. But then again, these worlds are so small I don't need navigation skills. But speaking of small worlds, flat world should also be larger now, and you've got a fence to indicate where the border is, so no more flying into invisible walls. There also have been some improvements, but I'll straight go ahead to the biggest improvement of all, which is so amazing it's one of the best features in this update. Vacuum pumps can now suck up pigment flowers, which adds a whole new layer of automation to the game. Natural cotton can be picked up this way too. That is, if you find cotton first. But now you can build flower and cotton collecting vehicles. A whole new class of vehicles, just with this update. And it gets even better! We can pick up any item from the ground. No matter what. We could even suck up a vacuum pump with a vacuum pump. Vacuumception! But no, seriously, this is really amazing, because now we could automate the collection of honey, milk, or glow poop, or circuit boards and component kits we get from farm raids, and probably even more possibilities I didn't think of yet. You can now open the logbook in a seat, rotate your character in the main menu, experience new loading screens, experience a newly reinstated logic gate UI that is actually helpful. You can't run over walks that easily, and you can hardly push them at all, which makes moving walks even more a pain in the ass than it already was. Just move here if you wouldn't mind. Well, but give them one hammer punch and they fly around. The same applies to other bots as well. Creation previews should be improved. Saw blades deal a little bit more damage to small woodlocks now. The sputtling gun deals a little bit more damage. The chain attack timing of the hammer is tweaked. Also, the mod tool got updated to the latest version, so all the modders can have fun updating all their mods. PvP mod. So far, still no release date for Chapter 2, but apparently they're making good progress, and Chapter 2 will be pretty huge. So we better hope Chapter 2 can live up to its expectations. And lastly, crafting the beacon requires a little bit more metal now. If you like this video, check out my other videos, and maybe consider subscribing. I hope to see you again when the next update comes out.